What is up, people? Today is Friday, and it's especially exciting of a Friday because two reasons. One, I'm recording a live album tonight, That's very exciting. The second thing that's very exciting, and maybe more exciting, is I'm getting a new shipment of sticks from Vic Firth. I wanted to like show you the behind the scenes of like what it's actually like to be an endorsed artist. When I was in college, I knew that some people had endorsements and whatever, and like, you know, I'd grown up reading Modern Drummer and all of that stuff. And growing up reading Modern Drummer, you know, you always just think that endorsements are this magical thing where, you know, you're a good enough drummer that you just like get free stuff sent to you because that company likes you and then everything is great. That's not really how it is in real life. When I was in college, I graduated and I started touring full time and I was like, okay, I'm ready. I'm going to get an endorsement. I'm going to get free stuff and whatever. And then I realized that like no one's really at this point giving out free stuff. They are, but you either have to have a huge audience online or you have to play for a huge artist. Those are like the two ways to do it. You have to have some kind of audience that's huge for people to send you free stuff. Now, outside of getting free stuff, there are also other artists in endorsements from companies. You know, sometimes it's you get, you know, you can buy at our cost, or sometimes it's like you get a 30% discount or whatever. So there aren't a lot of people that have endorsements where they're just getting endless free stuff. You know, I know of one company, one of my friends who's with a certain cymbal company, they'll send you the first, every year they'll send you like a set of cymbals for free. So you pick your like four cymbals, their hi-hats, ride, and two crashes that you like love. They'll send you those for free, and then everything on top of that is like a special artist rate. And I think it's just about your level of exposure and what they think you're bringing to the table. There's not a hard, steadfast rule of like, this is how you get an endorsement and this is what it looks like. I think it looks a lot of different ways now, and it depends some on like what artist you play for, what audience you have, and just who do you know? And that's life in general. That's how you get gigs, that's everything. It's partly who you know, partly your skill, partly your audience, partly your business, like part everything, okay? With Vic Firth, this is how it worked for me. This is my story on how I got endorsed by Vic Firth, because I feel like no one talks about this and we just think it's magic that like you play so well that eventually the company reaches out and is like, you're amazing, let's win. That's not how it worked for me. So I went to college for 4 years. I played a bunch, I learned a bunch, and I graduated and I immediately started touring with the band Remedy Drive. I start playing with Remedy and I'm on the road and we're playing a ton. And we're touring and we're playing some festivals and whatever. And I eventually, wait. So we played and I eventually am just like, okay, I've played enough shows that I deserve endorsements or whatever. So I just start reaching out to people, right? And I knew someone who was at Vic Firth. And, you know, they had mentioned, hey, you know, here's my guy, Vic Firth. So I got his email and I emailed this person at Vic Firth. And I said, hey, I've been touring for like 6 months now and we play festivals. So please, you know, make me an artist or whatever. This is why I love Vic Firth. And like, I don't mean this to be a sales video or like whatever. I just mean like, it's so rare in all the endorsement relationships I've ever had. Cause I've also had companies reach out to me that want me to be an artist, but then they're not really, it's so rare that an artist endorsement endorsee relationship is mutually beneficial, right? Usually it's a big company who is trying to use your audience to expose their product. And if you're getting free product, that's worth it. But if you're having to pay a bunch, almost normal price, if you're having to pay almost normal price for whatever you're endorsing, they're getting free exposure and you're essentially paying to use their product on, like, it just doesn't make sense. Like, they're getting the better deal than you are because you're still paying, yet they're getting free exposure. I'm getting ahead of myself. So I started touring. I reach out and I say, hey, I've been touring. This is what I'm up to. And instead of Vic Firth not responding, because a lot of these companies just don't respond when you reach out. They just flat out, no matter what you have going on, they don't respond. Or what they do is they send you back like a very boilerplate, like, that's great, good job, but no. Which is totally fine. I totally, you know, especially at that point, I was like, I understand if you don't want to be you don't want to have me as an artist, that's totally cool. I just like to know, right? So instead of doing those two things, Vic Firth sent me an email and said, hey, thanks so much for reaching out. You know, right now it's not the right time because you just don't have enough going on. But he explained to me why it didn't make sense. And then he did something that I don't think any other company would ever do for anybody that's not an artist. He said, stay in touch. Let me know what's going on. Check in every now and then because it's not right now, but maybe it will be in the future. And I think that's always true, and every company should always have that attitude. A couple months go by, I start recording the first album I did with Remedy, and I send him another email and say, hey, I'm playing on this album, and blah, 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 blah. And he says, okay, that's great, like, awesome. And then the album comes out, the one of our songs went number one at rock radio, and I said, hey, I just had a number one single on rock radio. And he says, that's great, like, stay in touch, it's still not right, whatever. Fast forward, I start playing with a country band called Gloriana, and then I reach out again and say, hey, this is the artist I'm with. And then it finally made sense because I was with an artist that they perceived as valuable enough to, you know, warrant me being an artist. And with Vic Firth, they actually send you a contract, or they did for me, they sent me a contract that said, these are the guidelines, this is your deal, this is whatever. And now, I've been with Vic Firth for several years, and they've treated me better than any company ever. And what I mean by that is, so the other part of these endorser-endorsee relationships is, you know, you start talking to a company, you sign on as an artist, and now you can't just go to Guitar Center if you want to, you know, take advantage of the whatever deal they're giving you, whether it's 20% off or you buy whatever they're selling at cost or whatever. Whatever deal it is, now you have to deal directly with the company. You can't just walk into Guitar Center and say, I'm an endorsed artist, I want this thing for this price. No, you have to reach out to your artist rep at the company and work out your orders that way. What that usually means is it's a huge pain and it's the worst process ever. You have to email them, ask them, you know, what's the prices for these things? They have to send you an email back with the prices. Then you have to send them back, okay, what's the price on this and this and this? And then they send you that back. And then you email them again and you say, okay, this is what I want. And then they email you, hey, give me your credit card information. And you email them. And it's like 100 different emails to do one transaction. And it's awful. But with Vic Firth, it's always so great. I say, hey, I want X, Y, and Z. They respond. And then I respond back with, okay, I want to order that. Here's my stuff. And they always respond like a real person. It's always a personal, actual, real-life person responding to me and then putting the order through. And that is super exciting as someone who, you know, I'm not Vinnie Caliuta or, you know, Aaron Spears or whoever. But they still take the time of day to say, okay, what do you need? Let me respond quickly. I've never had to, like, wait for weeks for an email. But there are other companies that I've talked to and that I've been with that their customer service was terrible. And now it's like, okay, I'm giving you free exposure and you're not going to respond to my emails? That's not cool. And that's never been the thing with Vic Firth. So no matter what company you're deciding to endorse with, maybe talk to some of the people that are on their roster and say, hey, how's their response time? Like, do you feel like they get back to your emails quickly? Do you feel like they're giving you the time of day? Because if not, why do you want to push their product and be, you know, chained to the only products that they make? And you're going to have to deal with all these emails back and forth and trying to, like, pry details out of it. Like, that's just, no one wants to do that. It's not fun. That brings me to today. I'm an artist. I put an order with them. They ordered it. They sent me the tracking information. And I realized that I haven't sent them an official, like, change of address. So they shipped it to my old apartment complex. I caught UPS and I said, hey, this is going to this place. Just deliver it to the store. So I actually have to go pick it up. Which is actually going to be kind of exciting because I get to, like, drive to the UPS store, pick it up, take it home. It'll be like Christmas. It'll be like me delivering my own Christmas present. It's like 12:30 right now. I have to be at the place where we're recording this live album at 3. So I'm hoping that I get a notification from UPS soon that's like, hey, we have your package, because then I can go and get it. And that would be very exciting. I was at Home Depot, and then I got a notification that, my package is at UPS, so I'm going to drive to UPS now and go pick it up. Hands down, that was the craziest traffic in a parking lot I've ever experienced. That was pure insanity. I'm at UPS though, and I'm gonna go get my stuff now. To summarize the whole endorsement thing, don't pursue an endorsement with a company you don't believe in. If you don't like their product, just because they're giving it for free or for discounted, doesn't mean it's a good relationship for both of you, both for the company and yourself. You don't wanna be tied to a company that you don't actually believe in, because chances are, if they're willing to bring you on as an artist, another company is too, maybe just not right now or whatever, and if you,
you know, jump into an agreement with some company you don't like that much, then in a year you might have to leave and it's awkward because this other company, you know. Endorse products that you really, really like and everything will be totally fine. And just know that endorsement deals probably don't work exactly like you wish they did or wish they would. So just tread lightly, be careful, and try to find out actually as much as you can about the deal before you enter it. Because it can get weird pretty quick. I've had a lot of friends that have had a lot of weird stories because of it. But that's never been a problem with Vic Firth. And that brings me to my package. So I'm going to open this. This is an 8-pound package and it is very heavy. But what I got today was, as you can imagine, some sticks. And then an accessory that I've been wanting to try out for a long time. So. Okay. First up, as many of you know, I play the Vic Firth Barrel Tip 5Bs. These are like normal 5Bs, which as far as weight and how they're shaped, except they have a barrel tip, which I personally think that the barrel tip has way more cymbal articulation, way more crispness, except beside, way more crispness. That it has a way more articulate sound than the acorn tip they usually use. What some of you might not know is that I also play the SD2 or the Bolero stick. This stick is great for jazz. It's got a huge, really fat body, and then it's got a little tiny rounded tip, which again is amazing for cymbal articulation. And because the stick is so fat, when you're playing at quieter volumes, the stick still sounds really huge and big and round because the body of it is so big, but it's not dense and it's not heavy. It's just kind of got a fat body. And I did a video of a Benny Greb stick review that used a couple different sticks. Go check that out because you can really hear the difference between the however many different sticks I used in that video. So link in the description for that. Lastly, this accessory is a Vic Kick beater. It is the Vic Kick fleece beater. So it's really big and puffy. So fleece material. So most beaters, you know, are made of felt or plastic or whatever. And they have a lot of attack, which is good. But when I do jazz and sometimes when I do really soft, like vibey type stuff in the studio, a big puffy beater like this with very soft material gets a really good sound. So the jazz kit you've seen me play in more recent videos, I did a one mic recording video, I'll link in the description. I was using a fleece beater like this, but it's really beat up because it's made by another company and it's not made that well. And that's why I ordered this, because I have a feeling that this will hold up much better and will be a much more amazing product. So I'll probably do a review of this. If you want that, put it in the comments below, like thumbs up or whatever. All right, I literally have to go do this live recording, but that's my unboxing. So see you soon.